Greetings, my name is Elizabeth, and welcome to this episode here on the Attribute Holder Modifier inside of 3D Studio Max. I'm now going to read from the documents inside of 3D Studio Max to explain to you what the modifier is providing for us. The Attribute Holder Modifier is an empty modifier that provides a readily accessible user interface on the modifier panel to which you can add custom attributes. It has no user interface of its own. The interface consists solely of those attributes you assign to it. So what this means for us is that we're creating a modifier within a modifier, sort of like that. So what we're now going to be doing is to add our own custom attributes to the modifier. So let's go ahead and do that. So the first thing you want to do is to convert your model into an editable poly, and then add the modifier onto your model. If you now look into your command panel, you can see that you have nothing you can change there. It's completely empty, and in order for you to add your custom attributes, you need to add your own buttons and things like that. The way you do that is by pressing X on the keyboard and search for parameters. When you find parameter editor, go ahead and press that. You can alternatively open up the parameter editor by pressing Alt 1 on your keyboard or go into animation and open the window that way. When the window is opened up, you want to make sure that the Add to Type is on Selected Object Current Modifier. You want to make sure the parameter type is going to be Float, and the UI type is going to be Slider. You can now name your parameter if you want to do that. I'm going to name mine to Slider or something. The rest of the settings are going to be fine to use. But I'm going to change the range from 00 to, instead of 100, into 20. So we should have the range going from 00 to 20. You now want to go ahead and click on Add, and are now free to close the window. If you now look into the command panel, you should now have a parameter named to whatever you named your parameter to. You now want to press X again and search for parameter, and select the one called Parameter Wiring Dialog. You can alternatively press Alt 5 or go into the tab called Animation, Wire Parameters, Parameter Wiring Dialog. You now want to focus on the left side and do exactly what I do. Click the plus sign next to your model name, then Modified Object, Attribute Holder, Custom Attributes, and then the name of your attribute. In our case, it's Slider or something. On the right side, you want to go down all the way to the bottom until you find Objects and the name of your object, Transform, Rotation, and in here, select the one you want to use. I'm going to be using X Rotation. By selecting X rotation, I'm telling my model to move in the X direction when I move the slider to the right. Now when both of these are selected, you now want to click on the two-way connection, and then click Connect. You can now close down the parameter wiring dialog, and move the slider to the right to see the result. If we now want to tweak some of the existing values that we had before, you can just open up the parameter editor and do that in there. This time I'm going to change the value from 20 down to 10. If we change this down to 10, it's going to move the object slower and it's going to be a more smooth transition. If we move it down even further, down to, for example, 5, it's going to be even smoother and slower than before. Now this right here is just a small example of what the attribute holder can do for you. Now you can even add on more modifiers and add them into your attributes and have a lot of customization for yourself. Now on a more personal level, I'm not really seeing myself using this too much. Maybe when it comes to animation it could be useful, but I'm not really sure about it. I hope that you find some use for it and that it will help you out in your daily workflow. If not, well, then you just learn something and have something with you. If you ever need the help from the attribute holder, it's right there in the modifier list. So thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day, guys and gals, and I'll see you as soon as I can. Bye.